guys, welcome to the vlog. Today is Wednesday, first Wednesday of the year 2021, and I was supposed to start this vlog on Monday, but I'm not sure if you've heard the news that so we just started yet again another national lockdown. Yeah, it's a bit frustrating, but people are a bit stubborn in some areas, so I think this is inevitable. This is going to happen because people are not being careful, and us being parents, we and having this new variant of COVID, we won't be comfortable. We won't be happy to send our kids to school knowing that there is a more contagious variant of COVID. And they said that in the news it's 50 to 70% the chances of transmitting. Even if it's difficult to have another lockdown, I feel safer that Sky is in the house, and also me and Jeff are not going to work. We are working from home, so we started working from home yesterday, and not gonna lie, it's a bit difficult to be working and doing some schoolwork with Sky and also doing some housework at the same time. But yeah, I think we have to sacrifice for a bit just for this to be over and just for this COVID to be contained. So yes, and I'm in the bedroom, and I'm just going to show you my, yeah, I put in a little bit of makeup on, and I'm wearing the magnetic lashes from Lola's Lashes. I'm really pleased about this lash because unlike the normal falsies, you need to like use the glue, and that ruins your lashes. So this one doesn't. It just have like a liner where the magnets cling onto. I'm just gonna quickly show you how my like happy corner looks like, my makeup table looks like, and my setup. This is my table, which I had for around 5 years already. These are the lippies, false lashes for the hair, and this one for the face and for the eyes. So I just have my iPad here, and this is my vlogging camera, and my ring light over there. I have my brushes here, and the face products that I use like every single time that I'm going to do a makeup look, or I'm going out or something like that. And I have this palette from RCMA, some eyeshadow palette, and this eyeshadow palette from Morphe. And yeah, these are just the essentials that I use every single time. Guy, it's time for the registration, darling. Good morning. It's so sleepy. Come on. We're going to start the schoolwork. Everyone's in the meeting already. Wakey wakey. Wakey wakey. Good morning. Hello. Wakey wakey, my darling. Good morning, Murphy. Good morning, baby boy. Come on. Good morning, everybody. Today is Thursday and it's working day. I got ready for a little bit. I have put on a little bit of makeup and I'll show you our setup in the living room, dining, office. Hey guys, it's 6 o'clock and I'm finally done with work today, and Sky is also done with her school. This is what I wore today, my good old sweater from Palette Shop. Guys, if you're interested with some shirts and some sweater like this one, I will link this Palette Shop page down below in the description box. If you're interested, go and check out their website. And I know that they ship internationally, so yeah, this hoodie is so cool, like that. And the color is really nice as well, really pink and girly and cutie. Yeah, so today we just another work day. Not gonna lie, it's just really difficult when I feel like, I don't know if it's just me or you can relate as well, I feel like you're more tired if you're working from home, because you're working and at the same time you're doing something else, like you have to cook, you have to, and especially that Sky is also is also homeschooled for the meantime, schools are closed. So yeah, not gonna lie, it's very challenging, but yeah, we hope to pull through. Tomorrow is Friday, so I think we're just going to have like a design team meetings around 2 hours, like that. Package what I ordered in a bit. Yeah, it's actually for a phone case for this new phone. So one more thing, we have Bromptons. I'll show you guys in a bit how our Bromptons look like. Yeah, I also ordered an accessory for my Brompton bike. It's an office bag and I won't be using it, not until the lockdown is over. I got some case for my phone and Jeff's phone. So let's open this. Ta-da! Yeah, it's a privacy screen protector. And so it's 2 and 3 of those for the camera. And I'm excited for my case. Ooh, cool. I think this is like the silicone case, which I also had in my iPhone 11 before. So yeah, it's cute. It's a nice light pink case. Let's see if it fits if it has like a snug fit. Oh wow, hooray. Ooh, cute. Can you see? I don't like pink that much. I don't know if you notice, I don't like pink at all. Yeah, cool. So I ordered this bag for my Brompton bike. This bag is Brompton compatible. You just have to order you just need to order the frame. There's the frame separately, but still on their website. So let's see, this is my office bag supposedly, but where am I going? I'm not going to the office anymore. So let's open it. So this is a leather bag that fits 15 inch laptop. So this is perfect for my bag. This is perfect for my bike. And so I ordered the bag and a separate frame. Let's see. Oh, oh, there's a letter. So this brand, this bag is from Hill and Ellis, London. Okay, so this is the frame. I'm not sure if this is called the C frame, I think. So yeah, so this is what will hold the bag. This goes to the bracket that is already attached on the Brompton bike, so it will sit there like that. So it is here. It's called Hill and Ellis, London. Welcome to the ride. So this brand specifically make Brompton compatible bags, and I think they are also have those bags where you can put on the rack behind your. I'm not really sure what it's called, but yeah, not for Brompton, but for. They also make saddle bags that are really, really interesting, really, really nice, and really nice quality as well. And this bag is leather, and it comes with another bag so that your bag is protected when it's raining. So I love this canvas bag. Really nice. I think it's really nice touch. Ooh. Ta-da! Oh wow! Ooh. Ooh. Ta-da! Oh my gosh! It's huge! And it's so nice. It's this one. So this is where the bracket will come here, but you're just going to put it and put the bracket there. I think I'm doing it correctly. Yep. So to secure the bracket, you would just fasten it with a Velcro. And yeah.
So I'm just going to quickly show you our bikes that we got here. This is Jeff's bike and this is my bike. So there are different types of bike, but they are Brompton bikes. So this is a six. This is an S type and this is an M type. So why is it an S type? It's because of the handlebar. So they're different in handlebars, but they have six gears. I'm just going to quickly show you how to unfold the bike. So this is how the bike looks like when it's folded. So you see that it saves a lot of space, and you can put it under the table, or if you're at work, you can put it under your desk. And this one sits in perfectly, like in a very tiny places, in a very tiny spaces, not like the normal bike. Okay, so I'll just go ahead to put this aside. This is very new. Jeff just got this for a week, maybe, right?
A week.
He just got this first week of January. This is the 2021.
Yeah, it's the 2021 version.
Yeah, this is the 2021 version, and then this is the 2020 version.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the Bromptons are released. The next year version are released like early or the last.
Say around December.
Yeah, so they released this around. I'm not really sure, but they are released like the last quarter of the year. So the next year will be released, the last quarter of the year, the next models.
But they don't really change a lot. I mean, iterations of version doesn't really have those because like if you're going to look at Brompton now from say 10 years from now, they fairly look the same, just from
I think they
know,
just
maybe just minor
every
tweaks.
Year they just release like a new color, something like that, and this color is really nice. It's this is the black edition S6L 2021, and this is the normal version. This is like a normal edition M6L in white. Jeff's is the black edition. It means that all the hardwares, all that you can see here is black, and this one is an upgrade as well. It has the original what do you call this again?
Saddle.
Yes. So I'm going to unfold my bike so that you can see how it looks like when it's unfolded and how nice it looks like when it's unfolded. So I'll just put this on the side. The first one is you're gonna put the pedals like this. You're gonna raise the saddle to its fullest, and then you're going to raise the handlebar like that. Fix this bracket over here and turn it. Yep, and then just kick it like that. There you go. And then you put the last bracket. I just fix the last bracket and then adjust the saddle based on your height. So yeah, bike is ready. You're ready to go. You can put your bags in here because there's already your bracket, and you can also put like, what do you call that thing?
There's like a rear rack available, but we didn't opt for that one because we don't really.
Yeah, but it doesn't come with the bike.
You can actually opt for a bike with a rack.
Okay,
so our models are like X6, S6L, and M6L.
Mm-hmm.
L being to have only mud guards. If you will opt for the rack, it will be on your type, it will be M6R.
Okay, rack.
Rack, yeah.
Okay, so yeah, this is how the bike looks like. This size and this type of bike is just really convenient for everyday commute to work, especially as I think our house to our work is only around 20 for me, 20 minute bike ride, or for Jeff.
Is it? I don't think it's 15. Like that.
Yeah.
Maybe around 15-10 minutes. 15 minutes to you and 10 minutes for me.
Yeah, so this is how the bike looks like. Let me know in the comments below if you want to see like a detailed video about the bikes that we got, the accessories that we got. I remember I showed you what do you call that, the bike that I have, that the bag that I bought the other day, I ordered the other day, but sadly I had to return it. What else? Yeah, we have the Brompton Life, Brompton Cat Eye lights over there and on the rear. And yeah, let me know in the comments below if you want like a detailed video of the bike. Guys, it's a Friday, work week is over at last. Office work is done, housework naman. How was your week, guys? How was your first week back from vacation? How was work? How was the first week? I struggled for a little bit because homeschool and work from home is just I'm not gonna say it's a nightmare, but it's difficult. It's challenging, but it's a Friday.
I hope you had a good week. This morning we had about 9 o'clock we started our design team meetings again. It lasted for two and a half hours, so it was our first catch up from since we had the Christmas vacation. So yeah, everything is good. Our project is on time. Cross fingers. Yes, so yeah, I think I didn't mention this before. We are working on a luxury residential building. It's two blocks. Jeff is working on block one, I'm working on block two. It's a 25 story building, residential building. I'm not even sure where it is. I think it's in Manchester. So yeah, we are working on those projects. I'm about to cook dinner. I'm about to make adobo. Before I came in the bedroom, I prepared most of the ingredients. I cut the vegetables and the meat, and that's it. Yeah, I'm gonna show you how I do like our version of adobo, a Bicol version, or at least our household version. I know that when you say adobo, or when you say like what's the signature dish in the Philippines, most of the time people would say adobo because that's really easy to cook and really it lasts 4 days because it has soy sauce, even if you don't put it in the fridge, so it would last you 4 days. So maybe you can join me in the kitchen if you're interested to watch me cook, and also you can see how I do our version of the famous adobo. I'm making pork adobo and I'm adding some vegetables just so it's not boring. So yeah, let's go in the kitchen. See you in a bit. Okay, so the adobo is about to be dry and we'll produce the oil. Ooh, it's hot. So while we wait for that, I have here some onion, some garlic, some dried chili. I will put some carrots and some bell pepper, just so it's not boring. But the main ingredients when you're cooking adobo is you have the soy sauce, I have the sweet soy sauce, I have the white wine vinegar, black peppercorn, spice, some paprika, and then I add a bit of salt and a bit of brown sugar, and then that's it. So I just put some space on the side, and we're going to put the onions. It's a bit more. Just cook them for a little bit. You know the drill when you saute. And then let's get some garlic. I'm using this brand because this is already, yeah, exactly, very lazy chopped garlic. Now that we've sauteed the pork, you can see that it's a bit brown already. So it means that you can already put your soy sauce, and then some water, your peppercorns, and then your bay leaves. And then you can put this in the simmer. So that until the pork is tender. Yeah, let's put them in. to 40 minutes and then we'll check up on it. So it started to boil again and then we'll cover it in a bit. Let's check on our adobo. Wow. So this has been simmering for a while and we're going to add some brown sugar. And then we're going to add our white wine vinegar, and then when the vinegar has simmered for a while, and then we're going to add the vegetables. We can add the chilies now. Okay, chilies in the pan. Then we're going to add carrots in. Let me check how it tastes like. Oh, wow. Oh, it looks beautiful. The last thing that we're going to do is to put the peppers in. Oh, it smells so good. It's colorful fish. And our rice is ready. Yum. Oop. One last taste. Let's check. Tastes good to me. Let's eat. Good morning. It's a Saturday morning. And everything is freezing. It's beautiful, isn't it? Thank you. guys, just finished recording a makeup look for a tutorial again. Yeah, I haven't done a makeup look in a while, so I figured I'll make another video. And for that, I'm going to finish this vlog. I hope you had a wonderful time watching our videos. And yeah, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and don't forget to like this video as well. And I'll see you in our next vlog. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!